The sun. Oh, how I love the sun. I could revel in the sun all day, every day. But have you ever heard of the term too much of a good thing? Because when it comes to the sun, you can absolutely have too much. And if you do, it's not pretty. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all manner of queries, bright and beautiful, or questions big and small. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the sun never sets? Before we get into this video, I want to hear from you. Are you a daytime person or a nighttime person? Are you summer or are you winter? Let a gal know. Also, while you're down there in the comments section, why don't you leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend? Okay, the sun. Our glorious star that keeps us alive and kicking on Earth. The thing is though, we kind of have the whole light, dark, sun, night, warm, cold thing figured out. It's a careful balance and it works for us. The Earth rotates on its axis, spinning at nearly 1,000 miles per hour at its equator. It completes its revolve every 24 hours, allowing for day and night in different parts of the globe as they turn away or greet the sun. Our life on planet Earth is unequivocally tied to this movement. The ebb is as important as the flow, but what if it was all sunshine all the time? It sounds great, right? And maybe it would be for a few weeks, we would all be loving it. Initially, our moods would likely be lifted from all of the increased sunshine. Social media would be exploding with images of us basking all day long, and bask we would. Although, I imagine there would be an increase in sun lotion sales as we need more SPF to keep those harmful rays away from burning us. But what happens when all of the sun lotion runs out? Can we keep up with the demand? Really, that's actually kind of the least of our worries. After the high of the first few days, we humans, we creatures of habit, would start to get pretty stressed. Much sunlight would mess with our sleep patterns, which would mean cranky people, sleep-deprived people, tired people. Tired people make mistakes and accidents would start to happen. There would be a rush on blackout blinds to help us get through the night. But even if we could sleep in the dark with blinds, psychologically, we'd be kind of sent insane by it never actually being dark outside. What would happen to nighttime activities? Isn't it kind of seedy to get that drunk in the day? Would we toss out light bulbs forever? Are we gonna retire fireworks? What would happen to cozy nights in, snuggled up watching a movie or drinking a hearty Merlot by the fire? The bougie hygge dream is dead, and it's sun, 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 all of the way, forever. Spare a thought for the animals of the world though. They can't buy blackout blinds, they can't simulate darkness, and they don't have opposable thumbs for eye masks. Poor blighters would be stuck in perpetual light, and animal life would start to react really badly. Many would simply die from the upheaval. I guess long story short though, we all die anyway. Hip hip hurrah. Without nighttime to help cool the land, global temperatures would rise to over 100 degrees Celsius, which eventually would mean that the lakes would evaporate, with drought making food production nigh on impossible. We'd barely have enough water to drink for ourselves, let alone give it to livestock. Fun fact for you, but did you know that to produce 1 pound of beef, you need 1,799 gallons of water? We'll be tired, we'll be hungry, we'll be thirsty, we'll be hot, and there will be no beef. Oddly, there would also be floods. With the sun always beating down on polar ice caps, honeys would be a-melting. The problem is though, they'd melt into the ocean and we don't yet have enough power to convert ocean water into drinking water. So while our drinking water supply would diminish, our non-drinkable water would increase. For a bit anyway. Eventually, the sun would start to evaporate the ocean too, which would be devastating for marine life. So, hold on a minute. Wait though. We live on a globe. A spinny, spinny globe. You know what doesn't spin? Our mate the moon, which means it has a dark side. If the sun was always shining, if the sun never set, it must mean that there would be a dark side of the Earth, part of the Earth always in darkness. Well, maybe not always, as I'm assuming we would still orbit the sun. The issue though would then be that the sun would never set for 6 months, and then never rise for another six. But if this was the case, it would mean that the Earth had stopped spinning on its axis, which would be a huge problem. Again, long story short, we would all keep spinning at the moment that the Earth stopped, which would mean that people, buildings, trees, cars, animals would all be launched into an unsurvivable spin. The Earth's rotation controls gravity, which we would lose too. So, fun, happy, floaty, smashy, either in brilliant sunshine or total darkness, depending on where you were. I actually did a whole video about what would happen if the Earth stopped spinning, so I'll leave a link for that in the description box if you want to know more about that particular aspect of the drama. So, if the sun never set? Well, the implications of that would be pretty catastrophic, not least for the lack of UV light discos. Disco, really, Rebecca? You show your age. But okay, let's get a bit more conceptual here. Back in the day, they used to say that the sun never set on the British Empire, because their global colonization was so awful and expansive that there was perpetually part of their territory always in sunshine. But fast forward a couple of hundred years and we realize that actually, colonization is a pretty terrible idea, and that chasing a land of endless sun is a bad idea on a socio-political level too. One last thought, there are parts of the world that actually do enjoy perpetual sunshine, for a few months of a year anyway. Now this includes North Norway, North Alaska, and basically places north of the Arctic Circle and south of the Antarctic Circle. Why is this? Axial tilt, that's why. But the offset is that there are months in the winter where the sun doesn't rise, and then once again we're back to the ebb and flow. It really is part of nature, and it is best not to be messed with. If it was, we might find we don't like the results. So that was that. What do you think to this question and answer? Also, don't forget to let me know if you're a day person or a night person. I'm definitely a sunshine girl, but this video has made me appreciate the night times. Also, fairy lights, yay. Do leave a thumbs up on this video if you like our content and share it with a friend. And if you haven't yet subscribed to Life's Biggest Questions, why don't you hit that big, beautiful notification bell right now and do it. Before I get out of here, I want to read some comments from What If We Built a Skyscraper with 10 Billion Floors? What a question. What a video. I really like this comment from Thunderfish294, who said, what if we built a skyscraper with 10 billion floors, as in floors? I mean, I would say every imperfection is a sign of beauty, right? Or something. Good. Isabella Sinodino said, did anybody notice that the person talking is Rebecca Folgate from Most Amazing Top 10? Hiya, yes, it is me. I do get around this old thing they call YouTube, and I cannot be contained by a top 10 list. Ho ho, no. Numberjack Futuro said, once you get to more than about 40,000 floors, you might as well be building a planet. Well, quite, that's basically kind of what I say in the video. We may as well be making, like, what if we built the Death Star? Actually, that's a great idea for a video. What if we built the Death Star? I digress. Anyway guys, thank you once again for watching this video, do leave a thumbs up. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.